Hey, my friends, and welcome back to another episode of the Year of Cooking Canuck. I'm feeling a bit like a farmer today. Did you know Ontario farmers raise some of the best pork in the world? Ontario also has a huge variety of some of the world's best apples. Ontario also is known for their mushrooms, both cultivated and wild. So today on Clearly Canadian, I'm going to be paying homage to those farmers in Ontario with a beautiful, elegant, but easy dish. We're making pork with apples, mushrooms, caramelized onions, and a whole array of flavors. Guys, you're going to love it. Let's get in my kitchen and let's get cooking. Hello, my friends, as usual, welcome to the kitchen countertop. So here I have all the ingredients that we're going to need to make this amazing dish. I told you it's quite simple, but the flavors are going to be unbelievable. Right, so what I have here, first of all, are two thick cut pork chops. Mine happen to be with bone in because I prefer the flavor. You can also trim the fat, but why would you do that? Fat's flavor. You can use another cut of pork if you prefer, but to keep it rustic and really, really yummy, I love pork chops, and I haven't had them in a while, so please try and use a nice thick cut pork chop. Pork is not like it was back in the day where you had to cook the bejesus out of it. It can still be a little pinkish, not bloody, but it can still be a little pinkish in the middle. And pork is actually lean, believe it or not, guys. It's another white meat, as they call it. Now, like I said, if you want, you can trim some of the fat, but I'm going to leave mine on. In addition to that, we're going to season them very simply with salt, pepper, garlic granules, and onion powder. That's it, because you want the flavor of the pork to shine through, because what you're going to be adding is going to be full of flavors. I have here a nice big bowl of white mushrooms. You can use the baby portobello or cremini if you like, but I'm sticking with classics, white mushrooms. I have here a Granny Smith apple. I prefer Granny Smith. I like the flavor, I like the texture, and they can stand up to cooking longer without turning into complete and utter mush. So I would suggest using a Granny Smith or your favorite firm apple. I have three medium-sized cooking onions here, yellow onions, plain and simple. And then we're going to need some chili flakes, hot chili flakes. You can leave it out, but it's really going to add to the flavors. You don't have to go crazy. Just put a little bit for that back heat flavor. You're going to need some brown sugar. So chili flakes, brown sugar, apple cider vinegar in this one, guys. Don't use any other vinegar. I suppose you could, but apple cider is the way to go. You're using apples, so it's a no-brainer. Plus, it's very good for you. I'm using dark soy sauce, but go ahead and use any soy sauce you like. But you're going to need about a quarter cup. And you'll also need about a quarter cup of the vinegar. You're going to need some Worcester sauce or Worcestershire sauce. I'd say about a good tablespoon or so. Salt and pepper, again. And garlic, which I forgot to bring out, so you can also add garlic. So guys, this is everything you're going to need, and then you can serve this with any side of your choice. It could be mashed potatoes, it could be pasta, even if you want, it would be nice. I'm just going to go and make some roasted baby potatoes, new potatoes, as my starch to go with my meal. So that's everything, guys, and I'll show you what we do next. Basically, we're going to start off with our onions, so I'll see you when we start doing that. Hey guys, welcome to the kitchen. Woo, it's getting hot. What I have in here is some butter with olive oil. I've gone ahead and sliced up my mushrooms. I'm going to turn down this pan. I'm going to add them to my pan. Turn down this heat a bit. I just recently had my hob looked at because the gas wasn't coming out as strong as it should, and now they fixed it. I'm still having to get used to cooking with gas. It's really high. So, right, guys, what I have in my pan obviously are my onions. And I'm gonna go ahead and keep this on a low and let these cook slowly until they start getting caramelized. What I'm gonna do while they're in there now, the season as you go, is I'm gonna add some sea salt and some black pepper. I like to season as I go, and you should too. Right, so they're calm down now, and they're gonna cook away, get nice and soft on me. Right, so in the meantime, I've cleaned my mushrooms. Guys, if you know me, you've spoken about this before, I wash them. I wash my mushrooms and I pat them dry because, as I always say, mushrooms grow in poo and I don't want to eat poo. People say don't wash them because they're going to absorb too much water. Well, you're not going to soak them. You're just rinsing them, getting the stuff off quickly, drying them, and that's it. For cutting, I like to just go in half. For this recipe, I'm going to leave them quite large pieces, like so. All right, so I'm going to continue with my mushrooms while these are going in the pan, and then I'll bring you back and show you what I do next. Hey gang, welcome back to the stove. As you can see, my onions are beginning to get lovely and caramelized. At this point, let's turn off the heat. At this point, what you want to do is go ahead and remove them. You're going to be putting them back in, so you don't want them overly done. So I'm just going to remove them into this little bowl if I can. They shrink down a lot, that's for sure. Right. Now what you have left, there's a little bit of the oil still in here. I'm telling you, this new stove is like whacked. All right. What you're going to do at this point is go ahead and add your mushrooms. Forgot to mention, guys, when I wash these and dry them, I always cut the woody end off. They're not very palatable and they're usually gnarly looking. So I'm going to go ahead and add these to my pan, and I'm going to season them. And looks like a lot, but don't forget, guys, mushrooms really shrink down. Maybe not too aggressively, but you know. Right. So that's it. Now keep an eye. If you need, yeah, I'm going to add a little bit of olive oil to this, I think. Or you can add butter. But they're going to exude a lot of liquid. And when they do, the pan will get quite, well, liquidy. But able to evaporate. Just a good drizzle of good olive oil. The olive oil in here is not going to take away or be overpowering for the other flavors, so you can go ahead and use olive oil. If you want to use, you know, canola, mazola, vegetable, whatever, you can. I wouldn't use like a sesame oil though. let me just turn that down a bit. And just keep at them. In the meantime, you can start preparing your apple. So I have my nice Granny Smith here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to peel this, chop it up into probably the same size pieces as my mushrooms, and squeeze some lemon over it just so they don't brown, and we'll just keep it aside until we're ready to put them in. All right, so I'll see you guys in just a minute. Guys, I'm down to my last piece of apple here. And as you can see, they're in pretty large-ish chunks. And I'm just going to squeeze some lemon juice over them, just so they don't go brown on me. Get out of there, seed. Right. Yeah, seed is not going to, it doesn't matter. Give them a little toss, set them aside. You can see, in the time it took me to peel, core, and dice that apple, which does not take long, how quickly the mushrooms have reduced. My cat's moaning because she's not paying attention to her. Right. So I'm going to continue until all this liquid you see in here is gone. And when that happens, I'll bring you all back. Gang, we're back. It didn't take long. As you can see, pretty much most of that liquid is gone. What's left in there is probably just a bit of the olive oil. And the mushrooms are getting a little color on them, which is nice. You want a little bit of color on them. Not sure if you can see, but some of them are getting very nice and toasty. So, at this point, then, it's game on. Put your onions back in. And I didn't forget, add your garlic. Ta-da. Wow, the smell is so nice. Right, and then what we're gonna do is go ahead and add brown sugar. And I would say, guys, about maybe a little over a quarter cup. I'm not measuring it, sorry, because I don't want it to stick in there. I have other things. And what the brown sugar is going to do, it's going to counteract the saltiness of the soy and the salt we've already put in there. Then I'm going to go ahead with my quarter cup of apple cider vinegar. And that's going to add acidity. So it's going to be really nicely balanced. And then the soy sauce. Wow, it smells amazing. And to that, we're going to go ahead and add, well, a few glugs of Worcester. I'm not going to measure it. Put it to your taste. And you can leave it out if you don't want it. Yeah, I'm dropping things. Guys, there's one thing I forgot to mention, and that's a little bit of Dijon mustard, about a tablespoon. And that's going to add a little additional heat and a little more acidity as well, but on a different level of acidity. So that's in. Then, some hot chili flakes to your taste. That's in. And last but certainly not least, our apples. And we're gonna let everyone get to know each other. Hello, apples. Hello, mushrooms. Hey, bonjour, Dijon mustard. Okay, I'm being silly. Sorry, guys. And How am I stirring this? I'm being silly. I'm going to use my small spoon first. I'm going to turn it up a bit too. So, what you're going to go ahead and do now, the smell is amazing. Now you can also, if you want, add some dried cranberries to here, some sultanas or raisins if you like. So what we're going to do now is basically simmer this until it reduces. We don't want all that liquid. We want it all reduced into kind of a thick consistency. I'm going to taste it. Just if I need to adjust anything. Oh my god. Guys, it's perfect. Perfect. So, it has a little bit more heat, but then again, the heat will come in later, so I'm not going to add any right now. I'm going to wait until it's done. But there's the sweet, the salty, the bitter, the savory from the garlic and onion and mushroom. Oh, unbelievable. Guys, I will be back and show you when all of this has been reduced. Hey friends, welcome back to the stovetop. As you can see, when I push my spoon through here, it's not liquidy. It's kind of like a little bit of a syrup texture because you want a bit of sauce. So at this point, oh, and what I've done, guys, is I've taken my own advice and I added some sultanas in here. I looked in the cupboard and I'm like, bonus, I have some. Why not? So as you can see, I hope you can see that, but this, it's parting. So it's not like complete liquid in here. Like I said, you're gonna want a bit of sauce for your meat, like almost like a gravy. And that dark soy sauce gives it this really dark color. You can use a light if you prefer, but soy sauce is dark, guys. So I'm happy with that consistency, and I'm happy that my apples are still intact, my mushrooms are still intact, and I can still see pieces of onion in here. So at this point, it's going to thicken as you let it stand too. At this point, I'm happy with that consistency. If you want to go further and you want to make this more like a chutney, be my guest. But I want, this is kind of like the veg part of this recipe, so I want this to be more chunky. So, heat's off. Put it aside. Let it cool because you are going to reheat this and it doesn't take long. So let's get started on our pork. All right, guys, so we're ready to start on our pork chops. So, heat on. And I'm going to go ahead and season. Like I said, I'm going to keep this kind of simple with just some salt, pepper, a little bit of garlic granule, and onion powder. I don't want to overdo it with too much flavor because I want the pork to shine. Just make sure you salt that fat. And we have all that great flavor in our apple mushroom mixture. So let's go ahead and season. Make sure you get the fat as well. I always try my best to go high up. Have you guys seen that video of that guy who shook his or sprinkled his salt from like way up and it's all over the internet? Yeah, I'm not that guy. It's a little ridiculous. I'm just letting my pan get hot in the meantime, too. In the oven, I have my little new potatoes, which I've seasoned, well, tossed in some olive oil. Oh, forgot the garlic. I have some a little bit of paprika, and garlic and onion powders. Keep the flavors kind of the same, and then a little bit of dried dill. And the dill is going to complement because we have savory, as we do in the apple mixture, and we also have a little bit of the acidity. So the dill is really going to be nice in there. Right, so season both sides. I can feel my pan is getting hot. I'm going to turn it up a bit because I want a nice sear. Salt. You know, it's funny when I was washing my potatoes, I have a funny, quirky thing I do when I wash potatoes. I roll my tongue around my mouth. I don't know why. Do you guys have any quirky things that you do when you cook? If you do, let me know below in the comments because I want to know. I think some things are funny that. Or little rituals that you might have, or quirks that you do. Or maybe not you, maybe it was your mom or dad or an aunt or a sibling or a friend. So I can feel my pans getting nice and hot. And I'm so glad I had the hob fixed because. I don't think I've ever shown you guys on your Cooking Canuck me grilling a piece of meat because, well, at least not at this place, because the flame wasn't high enough. And I couldn't get a good sear. And I bought a really nice piece of steak and I was so disappointed because it's basically like stewed. And I had to finish it in the oven, which I was not pleased. I love these grill pans. And you can certainly do this on the barbecue, guys. That would be nice. Right. I think I've seasoned that pretty good. And I'm hoping we get a really nice sear. So let's go. Oh, yeah. Hear that sizzle. Awesomeness. Lovely. So in the background here, I have our apple and mushroom concoction, which I will heat up a little bit. But for right now, I'm going to go ahead and wash my hands. I'm gonna go ahead and get a nice sear on my pork chops. This is a great tool to have also to stop splatter. I hate having grease splattered on my stove top. So guys, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna continue with my pork chops and I'll bring you back when they're done and I'm gonna gently reheat my apple and mushroom and onion. Mixture. The potatoes are pretty much done. They're in the oven, and we'll see you soon. Hey guys, as you can see, I have some lovely grill marks on my pork chops. And what you're going to want to do, because you have a thick cut, is you're going to want to get every side done. So just hold it up a bit. And get that fat nicely grilled at the same time. As you can see, I'm heating up our apple mushroom mixture, and I'm just going to continue searing my pork chops. And you can see the juices are just lovely coming off this. Look at that, you want that nice char. So guys, what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue searing my pork chops, and then I'm going to let them rest for about 10-15 minutes, as you should, to let the juices redistribute. So guys, I'll see you back when it's time to plate everything up. Hey guys, it's all done. We have that beautiful bed of apple and mushroom and onion mixture on the bottom. We have that perfectly seared pork chop on the top. I did cut into a little piece and it was so tender, juicy, flavorful. I have my little roast potatoes over here with a bit of garnish of some parsley. And all that's left to do is to get some of those pan drippings. Oh, that looks so nice. And guys, there it is. So thank you so much for watching the Euro Cooking Canuck. Please like, please share, please comment. I love your comments. And if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Guys, please also follow me on my Facebook page, and the link will be in the description below. As usual, there'll be a couple of photos to follow. Guys, thanks so much, and we'll see you next time on Clearly Canadian. Ciao.